This tutorial demonstrates how to use the test case class fixture. Fixture refers to the type test fixture in the package aunit.testFixtures. Here is the interface to be tested, as in the previous examples. Because the unit under test is in a package called math, our test case then must appear in the child package math.test. First thing we do is declare a test case of type test fixture and provide it with some attributes to serve as test fixture elements. The inherited methods setup and teardown may be overridden as is done in this example. Note that setup case and teardown case are not available to fixture. These procedures are only available when using standard. Here we declare the test case scenarios. It is important to note that the test case created above, right here, complete with test fixture elements, is passed to each scenario. Hence, the scenario procedures become new methods on the class. The body of the fixture test case has two parts, the scaffolding and the scenarios. Because setup and teardown are invoked before and after each scenario, we know that each test runs against a background of a known set of objects and their values. Here we implement the scenarios as methods on the test case type. A description of each test is given in the previous tutorials. Now we having written all our test case scenarios, we may now proceed with the test suite phase. Here's the specification. Here's the body. You may recall from the AUnit class diagram that fixture is decoupled from the base class simple by the generic package test caller. Here we create a caller by instantiating the generic package test caller using the fixture test case as the parameter. Caller provides access to the test case scenarios on the fixture class. Here we initialize test suite pointer to point to a new test suite. Note that caller uses the function new underscore suite to create an access to a test suite object. This function emulates dynamic memory and is compatible with limited runtime environments. Simple and standard, on the other hand, use the dynamic method new test underscore suite. In this section, we create a concrete scenario from each test reference on the fixture using the caller create object, using the caller create method. And then we add the scenario to the test suite using the addTest method. We also provide a string to identify both the test case and the test case scenario. The fixture caller combination allows us to selectively address a given test case scenario. Contrast this with standard, in which the test case scenarios are encapsulated in the body of the test case and are therefore not accessible. Note that create, like new suite, is compatible with limited runtimes. If you want to prevent a given test case scenario from running, then just comment out the associated addTest statement as we've done here. Note also that each test runs in its own fixture, so there can be no side effects among test runs. The math harness has been explained in previous tutorials. Alright, now that we have a main program, let's run this. We'll compile everything. Build. Now we may execute. Output appears as follows. This is the output as a result of the put line statements to indicate that setup brackets the invocation of each test case scenario. Note also that the test subtraction is missing because it was commented out. And the output from the framework reports the 4 tests were run, 2 successful, 1 assertion failed, and a constraint error occurred. Both of these were planned to illustrate the output from the framework. All right, to conclude, fixture is the test case class to use when 1, you need access to individual test case scenarios, 2, you want to control which tests get run in the test suite stage, 3, your application uses a restricted Ada runtime library or a certified operating system profile, both of which prohibit the use of dynamic dispatching.